Hi guys, so today's video is inspired by a lyric from Zac Brown's song. I don't know what song it is, but basically I was in the car and I was listening to this Zac Brown song, obviously, and the lyric was something like, we have to go say goodbye to her because she only has 6 months to live. And I thought, wow, that's so interesting. How easily we hear something in the world we live in or in our society, and we believe it to be true because a well-meaning professional or everybody else believes it, or that's how it's looked for eons and eons. So without checking within to my own inner wisdom and my heart and the intelligence that I'm plugged into, I'm just gonna go along with the pack and give all of my power away to this other human being and take what they say as my truth. I got that from a lyric. And I thought, man, that's unfortunate. You know, and I'm not going off the deep end here and saying, like, don't listen to the professionals in your life. I'm saying maybe you have 6 months to live, but maybe not. Maybe not. But you will never know if you follow the pack. You will never know if you just continue to blindly make decisions based on what everyone else around you is saying. Now look, we do this innocently. It's habits of the mind, you know. We grow up in a pack mentality basically because we are afraid of being rejected. We're afraid of being abandoned. We're afraid of being alone. We're afraid of being different. We just follow. You know, we're walking around with our heads in the sand, like these little minions that are just keep, you know, playing out these patterns that are in our brain without stopping to think and go, what empowers me? Does this feel right for me? An example I gave today in class was, you know, I'm in the self-help community, which is around of a lot of like Eastern medicine type people and clean living and all of these things, which I vibe with, and I'm 9 times out of 10 among that, you know, belief system, and that's what feels right to me. But I'm a human, and this whole thing has taught me so much about balance, right? So I'm at a cafe the other day, and this woman and I, she was from India. We had this great conversation, and we were vibing, and she was telling me about yoga, and she's like, what do you do for a living? And I'm like, well, I'm a meditation teacher and a life coach and a communicator and blah, 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 animal communicator. And so we're vibing, right? We're in the same pack, so this is a safe conversation. And then I go to order my meal, and I say, I would like a BLT. And she said, well, if it were me, I'd get it without the bacon. Because, you know, who in this world isn't a vegan? I've tried the vegan thing, I've tried the vegetarian thing, I've tried the paleo thing, but now I'm doing the Jamie thing. And so I said to her, well, you know, I eat predominantly plant-based, but my body wants meat sometimes, and when I have cravings for it, I trust it, I feel more grounded, and I send the animal a prayer and a thank you. And that's where I'm at. That's what looks right to me in my level of consciousness right now. But I'm sharing that with you, and it took a moment of bravery for me to stand in my truth. But I could easily, and you could easily, no matter what group or pack you're in, do the things that group and pack do instead of thinking for yourself. And even in the health and well-being and good world that I'm a part of, I could easily fall victim to that. But you know what's really cool is my mentors, the people that are the most peaceful and the happiest humans I've seen, are beer drinking, pizza drinking, Gandhi and Buddha loving humans. They've found what works for them and what's right for them. Anita Morjani in her book, Heaven on Earth, talks about finding the empowering choice. If you want to do chemo, do chemo. But maybe your heart also says, you know what, I'm going to do that, but I'm also going to look into fruits and vegetables as healing. So I amp my body up. I had to do that during my healing journey from chronic illness. I was so, no, I will only do Eastern medicine stuff, because Western medicine let me down a lot as a child. So I was very anti it. And then finally I softened and came around and thought, you know what, I'm going to do 3 months of antibiotics to help me heal. But I'm also going to take probiotics and bone broth and all of these good things to help balance my gut out while I'm doing these things. So I've come to find in life that it's so much better when we don't follow the pack and we find the choices within. That's where it lives. So you can be miserable and follow the rest of the people. You know what's funny? It's like, it's just because everybody thinks it, and just because our society thinks it, and our culture, and maybe the United States, and maybe the world has these opinions, it doesn't mean that they're true. I'm an energy healer, and we talk about, you know, when energy starts, it spreads. And you can get a taste of this. Say you're angry about something, and you're just a little angry, and then you keep thinking about it, and then you get angry and angrier. You get angrier and angrier and angrier, and this ball of energy just spreads, right? Same with belief systems, cultural, societal norms. Starts with an idea. One person innocently goes, oh, that's a great idea. I vibe that to be true too. Then more people believe it. And then more people believe it. So then what happens? We're physical humans and we have these bodies and these eyes, and we look out into the physical world that we've manifested and created, and we go, oh, well, everybody else is doing it. All these billboards say this is the fashion trend, and this is how I should look, and this is how my makeup should be, and these are the types of doctors I should go to because everybody else is. And we grow up and we get a boo-boo when our parents say, go to this type of doctor. It's what we're taught. It's what's been normal because it's common. It doesn't necessarily mean it's truth. So then the energy of that belief system, that thing, gets more created in our world. And then what happened in my experience is then it starts coming out in songs, comes out in movies, comes out in TV, so we see it everywhere. And it looks like truth. It's just common. It's just habitual. It's not necessarily truth. So maybe that's the style for you. Maybe that's the diet for you. Maybe not. Maybe you have 6 months to live. Maybe not. There's these amazing things called miracles. You are divine. You have unlimited potential in you in every moment. When I was just teaching this meditation class, the thought came into me. I had the insight, you're only afraid because you've forgotten who you are. Who you are is God. Who you are is divine. Who you are is intelligence. Fear comes in as this weird, like, protector, right? I gotta follow everybody else. I gotta make this decision before listening to myself because I can't trust myself, you know? You guys, we haven't been taught that way. This conversation I'm having with you, it's not the norm. No one pulls you over when you're 5 years old and says, you have all the answers within yourself. Listen to the doctor. Maybe your intuition's guiding you to the doctor. Great, I go to them too. So I'm not saying don't go. I'm just saying, hear the song lyric, see the movie, see the billboard, hear the well-meaning professional. But don't take it as your truth. Take a minute. What feels right to me? What decision feels light? What feels empowering? What feels right? And then go in that direction. And then the more you start to learn to trust that voice within and your own intelligence, it'll just become second nature. And that is the ball of energy, that loving wisdom and intelligence and the space for miracles and the open-mindedness and curiosity of going, maybe, maybe not, leaves that door open for that solution to come through. But when we believe what everybody else does, it shuts the door. So then we'll only see that reality, and we see proof of our beliefs everywhere. There's so much hope. Your reality can change in any moment. So if somebody throws a blanket statement out to you this week, see if you can kind of notice, like, whoa, that's just what I've been living in for so long, or society's been living in for so long. And it might not necessarily be my voice. I'm used to living in a tribe that lives like that. And maybe it's okay to eat bacon or take antibiotics. And you create your new norm, like, labels, man, they can get us into trouble. So today, my wish for you is to be a label-less ball of divine energy, finding your own voice and what makes you happy. So thank you, Zach Brown. And thank you guys, all my love, and I will see you in the next video, okay? Have a good week.